Oh, welcome back to At Home with Matthew Green. Today, our guest, and we're sitting down, and I like it so much. So comfortable.
Matthew and I were just talking about the fact that Matt is really good at just wasting time when it comes
working
to exercise.
Yeah, he's a great penalty killer.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Stick handler. So
now that we're sitting, Matt's very happy, but we need to talk about nutrition. Obviously,
absolutely.
Very important.
Huge component, and people often equate that to what they're doing when they're at home. But to make it practical and to get the most out of your workouts and exercise, we really try to provide our clients with a lot of information, education on when to eat and what to eat. Not necessarily dictating to them, but just giving them a lot of options. Mm-hmm. And to make it really practical for them, on their first day of boot camp, we tell them what to eat before exercise and after exercise.
That's smart. A lot of people really do want to know what, because you hear all these different things. What should you eat before a workout? When should you?
Right.
And what about afterwards as well?
Okay, here's my question. I mean, you hear the Tiger Cats, they talk about their game day meal.
That's
and they
right.
always eat like a ton of stuff, right? Mm-hmm. They eat a big plate of pasta, spaghetti, mm-hmm. they
Perfect.
Had steak.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah.
So I'm eating that now.
Yeah.
But the problem is that after
you
I
don't
eat
have the game.
I don't feel like going to the game.
Yeah.
Yes.
They eat their meat after the game. They eat like this. They eat tons of meat. And steak
after the
and,
game too.
Yeah, they do. They eat big meals after the game.
What that speaks to is what we came to talk about was the glycemic index, and that basically determines like how your body converts carbohydrates into blood sugar, which then gives you energy into glucose. So what they do is they eat things that are low on the glycemic index. What that means is that it just takes a longer time for that to convert.
Mm-hmm.
So the carbs that you were talking about, the starches that you were talking about that they're eating before games will sustain them for a long period of time. A football game, 2.5 hours, mm-hmm. they can't have an instant rush and then a low. They need something that'll sustain them for a long mm-hmm. time and then takes a long time to convert. So that's something that's called low in the glycemic index. Another great example, yogurts, with skim milk, long grain brown rice, mm-hmm. Things that you can eat, and you want to be eating this.
This is what you would eat before you're working out or after?
You would want to get something in your system. I mean, primarily you need to eat before you work out.
Right.
So many times I'll have clients come in and I know they're not giving it their all, and I ask them, hey, what's up? Oh, I just don't have the energy. But that is really a symptom mm-hmm. of mm-hmm. something that hasn't happened.
And how many times do you hear people say, I didn't have time to have breakfast,
wow.
right?
Oh,
and
incredible.
You got to make time.
But even outside of breakfast,
then,
right? They come in and so for instance I'll say, okay, who feels a little bit dizzy, and people put their hand up, and I'll say, okay, what did you eat? And the answer is often nothing.
Oh.
Well, really, you have to really equate your body to a car. If you're running on empty, you're running on empty. You mm-hmm. have to fill it up, and we know what happens when we fill our tank up with sugar. Boom, it shuts down, it stops. So what we want to provide for people is they really need to get that within at least 2 hours of exercise, you have to eat something. You know what, it could be all fruits, veggies, just even a snack on the go. It doesn't have to be, a full plate or a full meal like the Thai Cats have before a game.
Yeah.
They're
not
that idea.
They're not going to be burning.
Calories in, calories
right.
out, Matt.
There you go, you got it, right? Totally.
Okay, so why when I eat do I feel so tired afterwards? I just want to lay down and have a nap.
Perfect, because you've depleted that. Right?
Okay.
So then that's a great example. You've depleted that, you're feeling completely run down. So what you need is something to replenish what you've lost, okay, in terms of blood sugar, in terms of the glucose in your blood. And what that does is you want to get something that has a high glycemic index. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be like a peanut butter sandwich, a Gatorade, things that have a little bit more naturally occurring sugars in them, an energy bar, again, all fruits. And what that does is replenish what you've lost, and then replace that energy for you so that you don't crash.
So ideally, you want to try to keep your blood sugar levels as level as possible, right? You
Absolutely.
Don't really want any spikes or dives, because that's what makes you crazy or really tired, right?
Totally. And what that also does is it doesn't prepare your body for what you're there to do,
mm-hmm.
which is oxidize fat, increase your metabolism, and really go after what it is you're there to do. Get the most out of your workouts. So things that, beforehand, that would be high in protein, okay, that's going to replenish, that's going to help rebuild your muscles after you've broken them down.
Okay, so do you go with the theory of you're supposed to graze all day every 2 hours, or is your thing 3 squares a day?
No,
okay.
I'm more with the first one.
Yeah.
That, as Leslie was saying, you want to keep it nice and even. What happens is we eat our breakfast or we don't, okay, and then we wait till lunch and then we eat. Then around 3 o'clock, we get real lethargic. Mm-hmm. Tired, you don't know why, productivity goes down, whatever it is, okay, then you go home and you eat, and then you're a little bit hungry again, at 9 o'clock. Whereas if you can keep like a steady flow of fuel into your body, then it's going to keep that blood sugar real level, and it's going to keep your metabolic, you know, system real level, as opposed to spiking it, dropping it, spiking it, dropping it. Because when you feel hungry, that's when you really start to store fat.
And so you should never be starving.
You should never be starving. Not only that, but that really speaks to what you eat for portions. Like, when mm-hmm. when you're hungry, you really, really eat.
Because it takes a while for your body to kind of register all
you
that.
You don't okay. know. But until like 10, 20 minutes after, yeah, you realize, wow,
like, oh,
I'm stuffed.
You know what, though? When I exercise, like I did the treadmill this morning before I came in here, I find that after I do that, then I'm even hungrier. Like, yeah. Like I have twice the appetite than I would otherwise. But you don't want to eat twice the amount of food, right?
Well, you don't have to eat, and maybe what the hunger speaks
well,
to, like
you do.
You've depleted your system, right? So yeah. You've really emptied your tank. If we're using mm-hmm. the car analogy, you've emptied your tank, so you want to fill it up. And the quickest way to reduce that feeling is really just to get something that, again, is high in the glycemic index that really converts fast. That's the only difference between high and low, is how fast the carbohydrate converts into a sugar in your bloodstream. So something that's low takes a longer period of time, sustains your body for a long time, i.e. through the game or through the workout. Something that's high, I mean, it converts now. So what we do with our clients is we have, you know, bananas, first day. Mm-hmm. We give them a sheet, we tell them exactly how it's set up, and they think it's funny.
Like, are
we a bunch
of
monkeys? Well, we give them the banana because that's a fruit, and that's yeah. going to replenish their system.
It has potassium.
Yes.
It's high in the glycemic index, and they get it now, right?
Yeah.
As opposed to later or wait when I get home. Another great supplement after you have your exercise mm-hmm. is chocolate milk.
I was going to say, that one I've heard before, too. And everyone always, you should eat within a certain period of time right after your workout, right? Like half an hour, just get something in your system?
Yeah, 20 minutes to a half hour, absolutely.
Okay. Now, if you didn't have chocolate milk at home, but you had chocolate cake, which...
Don't know that that works out the same. Okay. Don't know that that works
during
out the
cool
same.
During your cool down?
But with all the information and all the products out there, and the costs for protein shakes and supplements, mm-hmm. and it doesn't have too many carbs, is it balanced, you know, what all the questions, you just go back to what's simple and what works.
And
you know, $1.50, well, what else would work is again mm-hmm. like jelly beans, something that's really accessible. You can mm-hmm. have those. I mean, those are high in sugar, but mm-hmm. they'll bring you back to where you go. Okay. A peanut butter sandwich, mm-hmm. real simple, again, all fruits that okay. have naturally occurring, like fructose, that gets it right back into your system.
Now, a few minutes ago, we were talking about, you know, not eating enough, and then or eating just three meals a day, and then, you know, you get hungry around 3 o'clock in the afternoon, then you get hungry around 9 o'clock in the evening.
Right.
Now, at what point should you maybe, you know, close the kitchen for the day?
Yeah, well,
like, because I've heard that before,
question.
Like, totally. You know, after 6 o'clock, yeah. you shouldn't,
yeah.
like, what's
no
your
carbs
rule of,
after
of
six.
Yeah.
There's a ton of rules out there, but the idea is that by that time, with your body winding down and getting ready to go to sleep and then having that, you know, that fast over the night, mm-hmm. is you want to make sure that up until then, you don't have to have that big meal at 9. Mm-hmm. So what that tells you, if you're really hungry at 9, is that you haven't done what you should do up until then. So what I would suggest is not so much about when to shut it down, because the fact is, if you've shut it down at 6 and you haven't had what you should have before then, you're really putting yourself in a starvation mode. So just to say, well, I haven't had anything all day, but it's 8 o'clock and I can't eat after 8, and you just go to bed without eating at all.
Yeah, that's not good either.
Counterindicative to what you want to do. So as a general rule of thumb, mm-hmm. if you're hungry, that's your body telling you that you're not doing what you should do. So eat more frequently, spaced out throughout the day, balanced, mm-hmm. which is why they call a breakfast, because you're breaking the fast, mm-hmm. i.e. the 8 hours that you haven't mm-hmm. had anything to eat, replenishing your system. So just try to eat more consistently. So maybe it's at 8 o'clock, 10:50. You know, back when we were in elementary school with the recesses.
Yeah,
kind of
you had
sense,
the regular
right?
snack.
Right?
Yeah.
It's real simple. There's not a whole lot
of... And that's what would keep you going through school, through class.
So
you weren't falling asleep.
I've got one more question. I know we're running out of time. What about if you're a shift worker and you're doing different shifts
example.
All the time?
So imagine if you're a shift worker and you shut it down at 8 o'clock, but then you had a shift. Mm-hmm. Right? So when you're a shift worker, like if you're in a factory situation or wherever you're at, you know, the hospitals, what you'd want to do is bring in an energy bar. They have little fruit packages that you can have that are natural fruits. Slip it in your bag or your purse, whatever it is, and you'll just have that accessible all the time.
Okay. All right, very good. All right, we're going to go to break.
Matt,
were you eating bananas when we weren't looking?
No, maybe I need one.
We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back and get active. Matt, thank you. We're going to get active right after this.
No, I'm sick. I'm sorry. We'll be right back.